Welcome to Lab 360, where we bring you all the latest news and videos from the world of astronomy. Aliens, UFOs and life in outer space, these are some topics that will be ever ambiguous, and the answers to them would only be found once we come in contact with extraterrestrial life. But when will that happen? For years, conspiracy theories about UFO sightings around the world have surfaced, only to be debunked by experts later. Some also believe that the United States is in contact with aliens, and that's why the highly classified Area 51 remains inaccessible to the common people. But again, these are just assumptions. There is no concrete proof of extraterrestrial life, and for now, it looks like we are alone in this vast universe, traveling in the ever-marching wagon of space-time. But things are going to change drastically. Years of research have unlocked many mysteries of the universe, but the question whether aliens exist remains unanswered. However, a former chief scientist from NASA believes that we will soon have a close encounter with aliens. Yes, you heard that right. Jim Green, who retired as NASA's chief scientist in January this year, told BBC, "Many of them are in places much like the Earth where we can receive the light from the sun, and we can have water. And not only in liquid form, frozen form, and vapor form. These are important conditions, we believe, for life." He added that they were making enormous progress, and the 40 years that he was in the space industry, they understood a lot of things they earlier couldn't. He also said that the James Webb Space Telescope would be able to help them analyze atmospheres of currently unreachable planets, and NASA would be able to tease us with some images of such planets. Jim called this a huge step forward, and that we could see some astounding discoveries in the next handful of years. He also said that the telescope could help them compare the atmosphere of remote planets to the ones they already know about. "We are going to be comparing these atmospheres to the ones we know. Are they more Venus-like? Are they more Mars-like? Are they more Earth-like?" he said. These studies could be the key to answering the question, are we all alone in the vastness of this universe? It will be interesting to know what such studies reveal. They could also confirm if any of the UFO sightings in the past were real. Well, we cannot wait. All the best, Webb. Humanity is waiting with bated breath for your upcoming discoveries. Right, guys? What will be your reaction if and when we find out that we are not alone? Let us know in the comments below, and don't forget to subscribe to Lab 360, because we bring you all the latest news and videos from the world of astronomy.
Upon discovering the existence of intelligent life beyond Earth, the first question we are most likely to ask is, how can we communicate? We are in 2022 now, and the question feels more urgent than ever. Advances in remote sensing technologies have revealed that the vast majority of stars in our galaxy host planets, and that many of these exoplanets appear capable of hosting liquid water on their surface, a prerequisite for life as we know it. The odds that at least one of these billions of planets has produced intelligent life seem favorable enough to spend some time figuring out how to say hello. Space research organizations around the world, along with NASA, have been in pursuit of making contact with alien life. But forget making contact, we do not even have proof that alien life actually exists. Now a team at NASA is hoping to change that. How? By sending nudes. We are going to attract aliens by sending them, wait for it, unsolicited nudes. Yes, you heard that right. NASA is planning to do so through binary signals outside Earth's atmosphere to attract extraterrestrial intelligence. An updated, binary-coded message has been developed for transmission to extraterrestrial intelligences in the Milky Way galaxy. The message includes basic mathematical and physical concepts to establish a universal means of communication, followed by information on the biochemical composition of life on Earth, the solar system's time-stamped position in the Milky Way, relative to global clusters. The project is known as the Beacon in the Galaxy, and it shows the various diagrams related to biochemistry of life on Earth, and two cartoons of the male and the female body, with exposed genitals. The entire message is in binary code, as it is the most basic form of digital communication. Messaging extraterrestrials has always occupied a controversial position in the broader SETI, search for extraterrestrial intelligence, community, which is mostly focused on listening for alien transmissions, rather than sending out our own. To many, the practice is a waste of time at best, and an existentially dangerous gamble at worst. Stephen Hawking, one of the greatest physicists ever, once warned that aliens may not see us as any more valuable than we see bacteria. If you look at history, contact between humans and less intelligent organisms have often been disastrous from their point of view, and encounters between civilizations with advanced versus primitive technologies have gone badly for the less advanced, he had said. Hawking went on to say that aliens could be vastly more powerful than us, and contacting them is not the best idea, but we are a curious species, and we will always want to know what is out there, even if it is dangerous. There are billions of targets to choose from, and the odds that we send a message to the right planet, at the right time, are dismally low. Plus, we have no idea who may be listening. What if we give our address to an alien species that lives on a diet of bipedal hominins? Despite the pitfalls, many insist that the potential rewards of active SETI far outweigh the risks. First contact would be one of the most momentous occasions in the history of our species, the argument goes, and if we just wait around for someone to call us, it may never happen. As for the risk of annihilation by a malevolent space alien, we blew our cover long ago. Any extraterrestrial capable of traveling to Earth would be more than capable of detecting evidence of life in the chemical signatures of our atmosphere or the electromagnetic radiation that has been leaking from our radios, televisions and radar systems for the past century. So the question remains, should we send messages to aliens? Just because it would be difficult to achieve global consensus on what to send or whether we should send, doesn't mean we shouldn't do it. To finally know that we are not alone in the universe would not just encourage science, but our understanding about life and place in the cosmos as well. What do you guys think? Drop in your comments below.
Welcome to Lab 360 for all the news and videos from the world of astronomy. The James Webb Space Telescope will forever revolutionize modern astronomy, outshining even the Hubble Space Telescope in terms of scope and depth of discoveries and scientific advances. However, one of Webb's primary goals during its first year of science missions is to find and study extraterrestrial worlds beyond our solar systems, with a focus on how they form, as well as the possibility of them having water and biological life. Webb's research into star and planet formation allows us to link studies of mature exoplanets to their birth conditions, as well as our own solar system to its origins. Webb's infrared capabilities are perfect for revealing how stars and planets are formed for three particular reasons. Infrared light penetrates dust well, takes up the thermal signatures of young stars and planets, and indicates the presence of key chemical constituents, like water and organic chemistry. Mid-infrared light may pass through clouds that are 20 times thicker than visible light. This is especially important when looking at newborn stars that are concealed inside their natal clouds. As these clouds haven't dispersed for these young stars yet, we can't see visible light. Webb's infrared capabilities are crucial because they allow us to see, investigate, and grasp the early stages of star formation, when gas and dust are still squeezing inwards, to give birth to young stars. But there's more to natal star clouds than that. Young stars and giant planets both start off as huge, puffy structures that gradually contract over time. While newborn stars become hotter as they grow older, the giant planets become colder, but they both emit more light in the infrared than visible wavelengths. That means Webb will excel at finding new stars and planets and can aid in our understanding of the physics of their formation. MIRI will also look for heated molecular gas near numerous young stars, which could indicate the formation of rocky, potentially habitable planets. Astronomers will be able to reach an agreement on the concentration of bulk molecules, including the beginnings of ice, at the earliest phases of planet formation, thanks to such observations. It's no wonder that a large portion of Webb's early scientific work focuses on determining how planetary systems construct molecules that may be crucial for the advent of life as we know it. If you can't wait, neither can we. What do you guys have to say?